we celebrate that today. We're so glad that you're here with us this morning to celebrate that. And I think we've got our folks lined up. All right. Brothers and sisters in Christ, through the sacrament of baptism, we are initiated into Christ's holy church. We are incorporated into God's mighty acts of salvation and given new birth through the water and the Spirit. All of this is God's gift, offered to us without price. And through, where's Valerie? Valerie, through the reaffirmation of our faith, we renew the covenant declared in our baptism. We acknowledge what God is doing for us, and we affirm our commitment to Christ's holy church. And friends, you see in front of you a handful of folks who are coming forward to join the church. Some are coming to be baptized, and Valerie is here to reaffirm her baptism. So we're kind of seeing it all today. And we're going to ask all of you the questions at the same time. And we need to see an answer where everybody out there can hear you, okay? And let's see, Dee and Mike, y'all are also sharing responses for Savannah and Aubrey this morning. And so, but Savannah and Aubrey, we want y'all to answer out as well, okay? Savannah? All right, out. All right, here we go. This is to everybody. On behalf of the whole church, I'm going to come down here. I feel like, there we go. On behalf of the whole church, I ask you, do you renounce the spiritual forces of wickedness, reject the evil powers of this world, and repent of your sin? If you do, say, I do. Do you accept the freedom and the power God gives you to resist evil, injustice, and oppression in whatever forms they present themselves? If you do, say, I do. All right, this is the best question. This leads up to this one, okay? All right. Do you confess Jesus Christ as your Savior? Do you put your whole trust in His grace and promise to serve Him as your Lord in union with the church which Christ has opened to people of all ages, nations, and races? If you do, say, I do. Amen. And a question for Savannah and Aubrey, for Mike and Dean. Will you nurture these children in Christ's holy church, that by your teaching and example, they may be guided to accept God's grace for themselves, to profess their faith openly and lead a Christian life? If you will, say, I will. Excellent. And to all of you again, according to the grace given to you, will you remain faithful members of Christ's holy church and serve as Christ's representatives in the world? If you will, say, I will. Amen. Congregation, anytime someone joins the church or receives baptism, it is a time for us to remember our own commitment and our own covenant with this body of Christ. And so do you, as Christ's body of the church, reaffirm your rejection of sin and your commitment to Christ? We do.
We do.
We do. And then a reading up on the screen. A reading's coming up. There we go. Will you nurture one another in the Christian faith and life, and include these persons now before you in your care? With God's help, we will proclaim the good news and live according to the example of Christ. We will surround them with a community of love and forgiveness, that they may grow in their knowledge of God, love of people, and service to others. We will pray for them, that they may grow as disciples who walk in the way that leads to life. Amen. Church, what we just did is we just committed to being part of this body of Christ, that in everything that we do is about making disciples. So if we were greeters this morning out in the parking lot, that's part of making disciples. And those that help hold the bulletins, those that sing in the praise team and come up here early, all of this is us working together so that we can do this, so we can make disciples. So thank you so much for that commitment. Will you pray with me? God, pour out your Holy Spirit to bless this gift of water and those who will receive it, to wash away their sin, to clothe them in righteousness throughout their lives, that dying and being raised in Christ, they may share in his final victory. All praise to you, Eternal Father. through your Son, Jesus Christ, who with you and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns forever. Amen. Amen. Aubrey, Savannah, I have an important favor. Will you follow Pastor Allison? We're going to invite the Lions to kind of head down here.
Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit work within you, living more than you. Holy Spirit work within you to be born in water and the Spirit. You may be a faithful disciple of Jesus Christ.
Spirit work within you to be born from the Holy Spirit.